Hey everybody, it's Linda. If you forgot to study or was planning on winning the test, this video will help you pass biology in under 4 minutes. This video will be covering chapter 21, which talks about some cute little fellow called Protists. Now, what is Protists anyway? Protists are just anything that's not animals, plants, or fungi. It's like when you're trying to clean your room, but there's always random stuff that you don't know where to put them, so you just shove them all in one spare drawer. And protist is a drawer for scientists. Most protists only have one cell. Some large protists like kelp are awesome, so they have millions of cells. The word protist actually means first, because they're the very first eukaryotes. These random little fellows are currently divided into six clades. 21.2 talks about how protists move and reproduce. There are three structures that help these little things move: pseudopod, cilia, and flagella. Pseudo means fake, and pods are like feet, so basically they change their shapes to move around, which looks as if they have feet. Cilia is a furry thingy that helps protists swim. Flagella is a long tail that goes from side to side to push protists forward. Aside from these three ways, some protists rely on passive movement. That is, they just sit there and wait for water or other organism to carry them around. So the next time somebody tells you you're lazy, tell them it's passive movement. Now, reproduction. Just like a lot of living things, protists can reproduce both sexually and asexually. Cell division, conjugation, sexual reproduction, and all that, blah blah blah. If you forgot what conjugation is, go check out my last video about prokaryotes and viruses. Alternation of generation is another term the book used to describe the process of sexual reproduction. A lot of protists reproduce asexually by producing spores in a structure called sporangium. Moving on to 21.3, let's look at three kinds of protists: autotrophic protists, heterotrophic protists, and symbiotic protists. Autotrophic protists feed wells, support coral reef, provide shelter, and recycle waste. For example, protist algae like Zenzella provide coral's energy need by photosynthesis. Kelp forests provide shelter for marine species. What is worth mentioning is that protists will grow in a region where sewage is discarded and recycled waste. However, when a population grows into an enormous number, create algae bloom, they start robbing water for its oxygen, causing the species to die. Heterotrophic protists eat other stuff for food. Here's three examples. Amoebas take food in their food vacuoles, digest, chop chop, then spit it out, pui. Ciliates use their cilia to sweep food in their gullet, digest, chop chop, then spit it out, pui. Others like slime mode and water mode thrive on dying stuff. For symbiotic protists, some are mutualist, while others are parasites. Mutualist is when the relationship benefits both the protist and its host. Trichonympha and termite are good examples. Trichonympha digests wood for a termite, and termite provide Trichonympha a place to live. Parasite, on the other hand, doesn't do any good to the host, and some even kill their host. Malaria, for example, is spread by mosquito and causes people to die every year. Oh my god, I can't believe we spend so much time talking about protists. I'ma try to make another video on fungi. If I don't have time to do so, good luck, people.